right.
Alright. Live. And we're good to start.
Okay, so... Three, two, one, go. Okay, so for the first mission of the game, there's a lot of tricks consecutively after each other. So, summarizing, I think it's going to be a bit difficult, but I'll try. First of all, I thrusted backwards to pick up the sword, even though it's depleted. The reason for that is that if you have the sword in this game, you have 10% faster movement speed. Also, this is on Legendary, and Legendary can be pretty brutal, so the one or the other death is to be expected. It's completely normal. There's one trick coming up already. The movement of these soldiers is scripted. If I do it correctly, I did it. Okay, I got carried by a soldier. Waiting for a checkpoint here. Come on. There we go. I'm going to do another trick right away. It was originally called the YOLO launch. Let's see if I can get it first try. There we go. You get launched by the cannon, the movement is scripted, and you go out of bounds if I don't fail. Okay, we're good. Go out of bounds into the building, and I skip a lot of fighting, saving minutes and minutes. And I press the button from out of bounds. Another trick coming up right now is called the door skip. I have to wait for the loading done on the bottom left. And then I can skip the door like this if I'm fast enough. There we go. The reason why I have to wait is that if I do it earlier, I would be warped back inside the building at this time. I did not get a checkpoint, which is bad, so let's just not die.
Watch out for the Kraken. The Covenant are trying to use it to break the Promethean line.
This section is a bit RNG heavy. Oh god. Okay, seems good. There's another trick coming right up. It's a second cannon launch. And if I'm lucky, I will get the checkpoint. If not, then I have a problem. Oh, no checkpoint, alright. Let's get this first try then. Okay, that's the second cannon launch. By doing that, I went out of bounds again, skipping a lot of fighting once again. Okay, there's a first actual fight incoming. These enemies are called knights, they're pretty hard to kill, but... Oh, I got pretty unlucky. Anyway, doesn't matter. Back up strats. Knights are hard to kill, but there is an easy way. I will explain it soon. If you pay attention, every knight has two cores on the side. If you shoot a core, they rage and the face opens for a bit, and you have to hit the orange part. It's a precise shot. But if you hit the orange part, they will die right away. I got pretty unlucky with this guy, but it's alright. Usually his core opens right away, but I don't know why it didn't this time. So I'm losing a bit of time here. It's the worst case scenario, actually. Ah, there we go. Okay. Don't let them through the halls. We need I'm going to explain a bit more about the game soon. It's just that this mission is very, well, there's a lot going on here. There we go. The rate of discoveries has been stepping up lately. Have you noticed that? Ever since Requiem. This game is quite broken, if you haven't noticed yet. But yeah, so about the game, like the actual gameplay, the main difference between previous Halo games is the movement. It's very different, like it's more dynamic. Halo 5 has constant sprinting, and you can use thruster packs to boost to the side. And you can clamber also, that's also new. And there's a total of 15 missions, of which 3 are auto-scrollers, so there's nothing going on there. And 3 of these 15 missions are played with the Master Chief, the other ones are played as Spartan Locke. Like, this is the first mission coming up with the Master Chief. And every Spartan has different abilities. Master Chief needs 4 seconds for the thruster pack to recharge, while Spartan Locke needs 3 seconds, for instance. Some details like that. Also, this mission is called Blue Team. It's very fighting intense, and it's probably the longest mission of the run. What I'm doing here is I'm taking the plasma pistol, and I try to get a sword by making the Elite Rage that is upcoming. Alright. If I'm lucky, the Elite will follow me so I can get the sword. If not, then whatever. Backup strats. And I did not get lucky. Since I don't have a sword now, I lose time on movement. Plus, as a reminder, if you have the sword, you have 10% faster movement speed. It's not a big deal though, it happens a lot. So this game has a lot of elevators and stuff, I don't know why. 343 Industries likes elevators or something. Gondolas, elevators, auto-scrollers. So the next room upcoming has a lot of enemies, and we avoid fighting on Legendary. We just run through the enemies and try to survive most of the time. We only fight if we really have to. So since we don't like fighting, and there's a lot of enemies here, there's a strat coming up. Let's see if I can get it. It's an out of bounds, spoiler alert. There we go. You're just getting out of bounds and just avoiding all the fighting. And I even... no, never mind. Sometimes this room delays when you do this out of bounds, but not always. When it doesn't, it's way more difficult, but if I play it safe, I should be fine. It's mostly these jackals that can be a pain. Okay, we're good, we're good. Stone Rifle Jackals in this game will insta-melt you. They're really, really strong. Central control is through those doors. And I skip a cutscene here by just jumping off the bridge. Sounds stupid, but it works, so we'll just do that. I have to kill these grunts in order to not alert the enemies in the next room. And we're doing sneaky strats here. There's a lot of enemies, some grunts sleeping on the sides. 6 of them in total. I'm opening this door. There's enemies inside. I wait for the elites to get out. That's number 1. And they have active camouflage too.
Elites, active camouflage.
Second one. There we go. And we just run through after killing these guys. We don't like fighting. Something about Meridian. Meridian's a bad guy. If she's active, what's she doing so far out on the frontier? Hunters, they're keeping pace with us. In this tunnel, there's a lot of suicide grunts. I'm doing the safe strat here. Marathon save. You can YOLO them, but it's not a very good idea on Legendary on the Marathon. Alright, so because I didn't get the sword before, I'll have to try to get it now. There's an elite here, the active camouflage. I'll just have to kill him. There we go. What I did there on the elite is called the noob combo. If you plasma pistol overcharge in the lead, they drop the shield right away and you can just headshot them and they will die. To waste the dialogue here. Also, another reason why I need a sword here is to instant kill hunters. Hunters are very strong enemies. They are really, really strong in Halo 5, especially on Legendary. And I need a high ammo count. 64% is good. If you look at the top right, you see the sword ammo. Because the more sword ammo I have, the more I can hit with it. And each hunter needs 3 hits in the back to die. There's 2 hunters here. Hunters. Sometimes after I kill the first one, second one with Berserk, if I'm unlucky, we will see. I will just have to try to kill him as quickly as possible. Okay, I got a checkpoint, so it's alright. And he's berserking, which is really bad. I tried to kill him anyway. There's another strat, a backup strat, but I don't want to do that now. Within the marathon. I just nade spam the hell out of him until he dies. There we go, he's dead. Hunter's down. The reactor core is just below us. Let's go. Running to the wrong direction for good luck, I guess. So this is a room where I have to clear everything. There's no way around it. So it's just a lot of killing, pretty much. Again, lots of Storm Rifle Jackals here. They are very lethal, especially in close combat. And my aiming is a bit off, but I guess I need a bit of warm up. There's just tons of enemies I have to kill and try to survive. There's 2 sniper jackals that can come out any moment, that's random. And snipers can insta-kill you or 2-shot kill you depending on what they hit on your body. So I have to be extra careful to that. Ah, there we go. Ah, I didn't get to kill them right away. Which is a bit bad, but I'll manage. And he's hitting me from the side. Okay, we got first sniper down. Got an elite. Second sniper should be around here. Usually is. Surprise. Okay, there we go. New comboing elites because I'm afraid of them. Ah, this is going better than expected. There we go, that was a clear. Oh, one enemy actually survived. I've never seen that happen. I've never seen elite survive here. That's interesting. Yeah, one enemy can stay alive in this section, so that elite doesn't matter. He's dead anyway, so whatever. He tried to sabotage the run, but not today. But yeah, sorry, the beginning of this game is a bit fast-paced on Osiris. If I forgot to say something, just write in the chat if you have questions about specific parts of the game. I can see the chat right now. I can reply to questions throughout the run. So don't hesitate. So in this next section, it's an open space. You will see what it looks like. I have to activate a button. And then I have to destroy, I think, 7 or 8 something vents that are spread across the room. But we're speedrunning, so we're organized. Override activated. I shoot 4 of them with a Fuhrer cannon, and for the rest I will take the Banshee. Eliminate the targets, blue team. In case you don't know any Halo games at all, the Banshee is this flying vehicle I'm inside right now. Why are you shooting aliens? Aliens are trying to kill me, man. It's self-defense, bro. Distro, where's Dutch J? I don't know. He might be in the Netherlands. I'm waiting for the dialogue here to finish until this barrier turns white so I can go through. It's also very easy to die here. If you get shot once by a Banshee, you're dead. I was evading shots all the time. Okay, this next room is the last one of this mission. It has a ton of enemies, it's insane. And lots of Storm Rifle Jackals that can pretty much insta-kill you. And lots of Field Rod Grunts. This room is really difficult, so I will focus for a bit. This room is a hell for speedrunners. Also, Fear Rod Grunts can insta-kill you. If you get shot by a Fear Rod, you're dead. So I'm playing this extra careful. I don't want to die. And I said there's a lot of enemies, it's insane. Oh! Okay, Fear Rod Cannon. Where is he? We good.
Pick up that weapon.
Okay.
Launch controls are here.
Launch preparation initiated. Fuel cells at zero.
I pushed the button, that's the part, you have to do it. And because I killed enough enemies, the hunter will spawn, I will try to insta-kill him. But this is a bit tricky, so I will hope I will get a checkpoint or something. I could really use a checkpoint right about now. Okay, there we go. That's good. And he survived. I'm reverting to that.
Get moving. More hunters.
There we go.
Blue team, move to assist.
My priority targets are these jackals, they're really lethal. If they get a clear shot on me, I'm dead. And there's another hunter in the room, there's so many enemies. It's insanity. But yeah, this is really the one mission in the game where you have to do tons of fighting, like a ridiculous amount, as you can see. I'm going for the ammo crate. Oh boy. Okay. So there's a new mechanic in this game. I don't die right away. Okay, my ally is stuck. I have to revert, unfortunately. But yeah, there's an amount of time where your allies can revive you. You don't die right away. There's a bit of time loss, but it doesn't really matter if I don't die anymore. Things like that are to be expected on Legendary. Especially on the Marathon run. Where you see? Looks like I can see the raid on bottom left, which indicates where the enemies are if they're close to me. Okay, when I see this dialogue, I have to set up for some quick kills. But I'm pretty unlucky right now, so I'll probably play this safe. Smarter decision. I got a checkpoint now, so that's good. Usually you assassinate these, you insta-kill these elites when they spawn, but there's so many jackets around, I have to play this safe. Much smarter choice in this situation. And that's the second hunter I have to kill. Come on. Fear rock grunt. Okay, we're doing good. I just have to see where the hunter is now. I can't see him right now. He's trolling me, I guess. I think he's down here. Yeah. He's dead. And this mission is over, thank god. Alright, so I have time to explain some things a bit more relaxed. One of the hardest parts of the game is over. 89 seconds. So in Halo 5 you always have free NPCs that help you out. In co-op you can play them. In solo you can assign them to like take vehicles, shoot enemies, pick up certain weapons and stuff like that. And they can revive you when you get downed. They can come in quite handy sometimes, but other times they really, really do stupid things that don't make sense and you die anyway. So you should not try to rely on them. So the advice is don't die. So the beginning of this mission is not very spectacular. It's an auto-scroller, another elevator. There's nothing happening for a minute and 20 seconds. Well, you can see the revive animation. When someone gets downed, they can revive them like that. I just want to show it off or see what I'm talking about. Also, it can be a tactical advantage sometimes. When you get revived, you have invincibility for like 1 second or something. That can be good sometimes. It's about movement. The thing I'm doing while I'm running. This thing, hold on. This thing. It's called a thruster slide. It's a glitch that was not supposed to be in the game originally. And there was a trick where you could muscle jump through ramps. But they patched that, unfortunately. You can still do the thruster slides though without going off ramps. I'm shooting the generator here to open the gate. It's on a dialogue timer. I have to wait for a bit until I go. You see the gate opening now because I destroyed the generator. When it's halfway down, I will run for it. And there's another trick upcoming. There is a gate coming up, and there are several ways to skip it. Some of them got patched. And that was a problem, but by now a new trick was found, which is actually faster than the previous strats. But in order to do this thing in casual game through, you have to kill these four soldiers you saw right there. And the door is in the timer. But well, we're speedrunning, so we don't do that. We do something different. I didn't get it. I have to set it up differently. I use the Warthog to... Oh, come on. Don't worry, I will get it, guys. There we go. I use the Warthog to... use a glitch where I slide off and gain height. And like that, I can skip the gate. Why don't you just run an unpatched version? Unpatched has a few disadvantages. Like, you die much faster when you get downed. And checkpoints are inconsistent. Things like that. Some weapons behave differently overall. And physics are different too. They change vehicle physics over time. It's better on patch in my opinion. Even though 1.0 can be technically faster depending on how you play it. But this is also the only place in the game where you use a tank. So enjoy it while you can. I missed, but that's alright. The ending of this mission is just a huge clear, where a lot of things can go wrong if I don't pay attention. My main priority here is to keep the tank safe from any damage. Because if I lose a tank here, then I'm... Well, how should I say it? If I lose a tank here, I'm screwed. Let's put it that way. I really need it. It's pretty much a spawn killing until the mission is done. But it's way more difficult than it sounds. Because there's a lot of enemies spawning at the same time. But yeah, the run gets more interesting, trust me on that. In the mid-game, there's some really cool tricks coming up. You have my word on that.
I'll be damned. The propaganda about Spartans doesn't lie. Listen, across the bridge, closer to town, there's others that could use your help.
Playing this safe, because I don't want to die. I have a bit of bad RNG here. And this guy's my main priority. He hit me twice, which is really bad. I think I should revert to that. I don't know where I got the checkpoints. Okay, that's good. I don't want the tank to be burning right at the beginning of the fight. And these turret soldiers are very strong. Okay, much better this time. I can't stress how much I need this tank in this section. Spawn killing, yay! Another turret guy. Priority target. So I targeted him. And he's dead, which is good. I didn't take any damage. So, the way the enemies spawn is always the same, but the way they behave is really different every time. Legendary speedrunning in every Halo game is a quick adaptation. You have to have environmental awareness. You have to know what's going on around you. And you have to react quickly depending on the situation. Priority target. Okay, this is good. This is going much better than expected, to be honest. That's already the last wave. Nice. There's two knights at the last wave. We need two tank shots to be killed. Apparently I missed the first one. And that should have been glassed if I get the dialogue. Okay, there we go. Waiting for the mission to end. Come on inside. So the next mission is an auto-scroller. Nothing interesting going on. Just waiting for dialogue. And pushing buttons and stuff. I was hoping we might have a word. Come into town and we'll talk. I trust you won't cause any trouble. We'll be with you shortly. Oh yeah, this game has three missions like this where you don't do anything at all. Which is a bit unfortunate, to be honest, especially for speedrunners, but, well, it's just the way it is. Jumping on the heads for good luck. This is an AI. Called Governor Sloan. I will summarize what he's saying in three words. Blah blah blah. That's the story of Halo 5. He's an AI. What's wrong with him? He looks broken. Rampant onset. Don't worry guys, I'm joking, but I don't think I'm going to say the story because some people might want to play this game. Best intel in a place like this. I have to wait for the dialogue and then talk to this guy and another guy. There's an Easter egg in this mission. I'm not going to say what it is about, but you will see very soon. If you hit this machine button 11 times, something is going to happen. Football. I'll tell you what. Our folks at Apogee are plenty strong. Don't think you vultures can pick the bone so fast. Wait, what do you say? Apogee? I think that's our location. Machine's button. So Apogee came under attack and then a UNSC. And we're making a goal. Find a network terminal. Whoop-de-doo. Artemis ought to be able to track down a suitable network terminal. Ping it. So that's the longest auto-scroller by far. If I'm correct, it's around 3 minutes and 16 seconds. And this is the end of it, thankfully. Alright, the next mission is called Unconfirmed. There's a trick right at the beginning that requires fast and precise movement. But it looks really cool, so I'm going to attempt it. I might fail it, but if I fail, I will try it another time. I think it's worth it. We could take the stairs, but honestly, stairs are overrated. So we're going to take the pelican. There we go. Much cooler. And we're doing this with swag points. But there's actually a purpose, speedrunning wise, to do that. If I go with the pelican, I don't spawn the enemies. And I can just set up to kill them with the rockets. I can also insta-kill this guy when he spawns a watcher, when he goes down. Certain animation. It's a very precise shot. And I got it. It's the short frame window. Not frame window, but it's a short window of opportunity. Now we tried to insta-kill these guys, but I kind of failed. Which is bad, but not too bad. But don't do anything really stupid now, should be okay. Just playing it a bit safe. Okay, this is bad. System down. Buck is not going to make it, so I have to revert. That's not too bad, the checkpoint. Alrighty then. Still pretty unlucky though. I just killed these guys. Like that, I guess. A bit of time loss, but nothing tragic really. Waiting for the shield to come back. Setting up for spawn kill. Here we go. Many things like that happen in the full game run. Usually this fight is way more optimized. Play this carefully.
Clear the remaining hostiles.
There we go.
All clear.
Blue team just left their prowl. Also look at the ammo count, that's for good luck definitely. 69. That's a sign.
Let's run a scan.
Like a map of Apogee Station. It leads down inside the mountain.
Mark the path through the door outside to the mines.
Governor Sloan.
Spartan Lock.
So the next upcoming section has some binary rifle soldiers, and the binary rifle can insta-kill you if you don't pay attention. There's five of them, but to keep the game balanced, you can insta-kill them with a headshot. And that's what we're going to do. After this door opens.
Stand back, snipers perched ahead.
All right, so that's one.
The Prometheans have this entrance bottled up.
Two, three. Oh, I missed that. All right. Four and five. Here we go.
Move up.
Roger.
Setting up for some crawler kills here. Hey, that wasn't too bad. I think someone survived, I'm not sure. Okay, never mind, I got the dialogue.
Governor Sloan,
which means everyone is dead.
Opening now, Spartan. Don't see any signs of blue team.
This next room is very RNG dependent. RNG means random number generator. It means, in common terms, it means I have to be lucky.
heads. Spawn gate, bringing more Prometheans.
The RNG heavy section is coming up right now. There's soldiers spawning here. If I'm lucky, they go to the right side. If I'm not, they go to the left. And he's going to the left. But I can insta-kill him, so it's okay. It's only one of them, so I should survive this. Which means I have good RNG. The best case scenario, both of them go to the right. The worst case scenario, both have turrets and they both go to the left. And that didn't happen, thankfully. So we're skipping a long elevator ride. And it's the most ridiculous skip, I would say. Well, ridiculous as in very obvious. It's just ground pounding to the area you have to go to. We save a lot of time like that. So for those who have played through the game, you might be familiar with the Warden Eternal. It's some kind of small boss fight that keeps happening all the time during the run or during the game. And this is the first Warden fight in the game. It's known to be quite difficult, but
something new. Defend yourselves.
I think we'll manage. Because we can spawn kill. There we go. That was the Warden Eternal fight.
What the hell was that thing? The Warden Eternal. He said he served Cortana.
In a casual playthrough, he can be a pain in the butt. Trust me on that.
Another quake. Bad news. Should get moving.
The Warden was protecting whatever lies beyond those doors.
Called it the Guardian.
Cortana is connected to this Guardian somehow, and that makes it the Master Chief's most likely target. We find it, we find him. Let's go.
Bail's down. Get her back.
Alright, so that was unconfirmed. What I'm doing here is a save and quit, because this cutscene is like 4 minutes long until you can skip it. We just hop to the next mission. It technically makes the game New Game Plus, but it was decided in the community that it's okay, because waiting 4 minutes for a cutscene is kind of unnecessary, really. Next mission upcoming is called Evacuation, and that's a quite tough one. There's a trick coming up literally in the first 2 seconds of the mission. If I time my movement correctly, my sprint correctly, my jump and my thruster correctly, I will deload the whole next area. Sounds stupid, but it works. I hope I won't fail it. If I do, I will have to go back to the menu and get it again. Okay, I think I got it. I got it. Good. Because I did the whole thing at the beginning. The whole next section is enemy free. We're just going for a drive. No enemies, nothing.
I'll take the gun.
Thanks for the good luck, Rexy. There would be crawlers, phaetons, soldiers, all kinds of enemies trying to kill you over here. But we deloaded all of them.
This is Governor Sloan, broadcasting on all frequencies.
Also, this guy is kind of sabotaging me right now. There would be an enemy Warthog here driving, trying to kill you. But nope, no enemies for us. The next section is a very, really tough fight that can go wrong in the full game, so I have to play very safe, I hope. I hope I won't fuck it up, but we will see. There's two ways to get into the fight. The water isn't supposed to be inside. I tried the cool way. If I can't get it, I will do the other way. Cool way, first attempt.
Governor Sloan.
And we got the cool way.
The space elevator.
Can't do that, Spartans. Got too many people taking refuge inside. They'd be slaughtered.
Understood, Governor. Osiris.
Tons of enemies here, tons of fighting. Lots of things can go wrong, so I need to focus.
Soldier down. down.
You got it.
Looking good so far.
Take that turret, Spartan.
On turret support.
Mount that turret.
Soldier. Roger that.
Take that soldier down.
Copy that, Locke.
Kill the phaser.
Thing is super safe.
Target the soldier.
I'm on it.
Solid copy.
Enemy's getting through.
All right. There's another guy right here.
Take that soldier down.
On it. Soldier down.
Priority target.
In room. Copy. One down.
I think I should be safe to go and get the checkpoint. Let's see. Got the checkpoint, perfect. Two bunny rifle soldiers. High priority target because they can be lethal. I'm playing this super safe. No need to go risky. If you melee an enemy from the back, it's an insta-kill. And that's what I just did. I was fast enough. He was on the turret, he was getting out when I approached him, and I was fast enough to get his back. Looking good. This guy. That's a very bad positioning. Come on, there we go.
What's taking so long, Spartans? Your propaganda is overselling your skills. I ain't opening these doors until the base is clear. We get to stop being polite with him real soon here, right?
Okay, looking good. Taking grenades for safety. I don't really have to, but you know, lose it a few seconds. I might save me later on. Spawning three soldiers up there. I will just cross cannon them to the death. Each and single one of them. There we go. I told them to take the weapon, but they're not doing it for some reason. Alright, I guess. Oh no, I missed the gate, the run is over. Reset. Just kidding. Yeah, when things like that happen, the Halo 5 game mechanic is that you get warped to where you're supposed to go. Tons of fighting again. Lots of enemies here. Have you turned off the assassination animation? No. Because you need it for one skip throughout the run. On Battle Sinion towards the end, more or less. One of the latter missions. I think it's the fourth last one. For those who don't know, on the standard layout of the controller in Halo 5, you have to press the right bumper to assassinate. If you hold it for a bit, it will assassinate. If you just quickly touch it, it will just melee. And you can turn that off. There should be... Oh, there we go. Okay, that was all of them.
Area's clear. Tanaka, how do we get the elevator moving?
After killing all these enemies, I have to push the elevator button. It's just a few clears here and there.
Master Chief seemed to think so.
So if she's there, then where are they going?
Again, this run is going to be more interesting very soon, trust me on that. The next mission is awesome. As always, I'm going to try to spawn kill a lot of enemies. And hopefully succeed. Nate spam! Another game mechanic I haven't talked about is the ground pound. And oh my god, don't die. Here we go. Ground pounding can be useful to recover if you fail movements. Oops, I didn't mean to push that thing. Doesn't lose time because the next wave is on the timer anyway. I'm known to have a lot of trouble with this upcoming wave, so I'm probably going to fail. There's Hydra soldiers and one Hydra is an insta-kill. And turret soldiers, who also can insta-kill you. So this section is quite difficult. Oh, how did that miss? Really? There's a lot of warping. Okay, that's a Hydra rocket. I survived that because I saw it in the last second. They can insta-kill you if you don't pay attention. What was I going to say? I didn't remember. Someone take that weapon. Hello? Can anyone hear me? I'm at Meridian Station. Everyone's dead. Governor Sloan isn't here. Yeah, the Hydra soldier distracted me. Oh yeah, I was going to say, soldiers in this game, they warp around a lot, and when they do that, you can't hit them. The next upcoming patch is going to reduce that massively. They're doing some campaign changes. Also, this is a White Knight. White Knights are quite strong, but I'm insta-killing him. If I don't fail, there we go. I'm taking his incineration cannon, which is a really strong weapon to kill these two knights. The spawns are random, by the way. I got pretty lucky. The white knight always spawns at the same location, the black ones don't. Alright, so that was the last clear for this mission. And this next upcoming section is quite fun to watch. There is a faster way to do what I'm doing right now, but I'm doing the cooler looking way. It's a parkour, how should I call it? Yeah, let's call it parkour. I tried to get on top of the whole thing as quickly as possible. This is pretty fun to watch if I don't fail. I haven't done this in a while. I do another strat. Usually. Oh, there we go. Everyone all right? Climbing! If I'm fast enough, I can skip a wave animation. And I got it. Usually you fall to the ground and stuff. And that was evacuation. Now this next upcoming mission is awesome. You will see why.
There have been 5 more events following Meridian. It's 11 colonies. I need a means to stop this now.
The Warden confirmed Dr. Halsey's theory. Cortana is activating the Guardians.
But not this one. Not yet.
Phanion. A pre-Covenant religious site on San Helios.
It's a Guardian on the Elite homeworld?
If we can get a team on the ground, we can access that.
It takes a while till you can skip cutscenes in the game for some reason.
Brass wants nothing to do with the Arbiter's War.
You can skip some of them completely, others you have to wait for a bit. Why? I don't know, it's just how the game is programmed, I guess. Okay, reunion. We're starting with a skip, a pretty cool one too. In casual game through, you should go and push a button and go down an elevator and stuff. We don't do that. We do something completely different. We go out of bounds. I kind of failed. So I have to go the long way around. Let's see, we're walking in the air right now. We haven't noticed yet. I'm a wizard, it's confirmed. Okay, that was a big fail, but doesn't matter. That saves around half a minute, more or less, I don't know exactly. Maybe 40 seconds, if done correctly, which I didn't do correctly. Have to go the long way around and stuff. Also, this section is quite difficult, so I might have to focus again. There's a Sniper Jackal here, who can insta-kill. And the Furot Grunt, who can also insta-kill. And we're good. Show some love for the Needler. It's the only place in the run I use it. And I got the checkpoint, which is perfect. There's another skip upcoming, because one is not enough. This one's pretty cool too. I might die here though, because lots of enemies. It's called the Reunion Phantom Skip, and it saves a lot of time. You would have to go there, clear all the enemies, push the button, and etc. We don't do that. We do this. We use a phantom, and we skip the whole section. I have to hit the load in the back, that's why I went back. But as I said, in normal play, we would have to kill all the enemies, go inside the building there, push a button, go down the elevator and stuff like that. So this skip saves minutes on Legendary. And that's not enough. There's another trick upcoming.
Chief.
It's another out of bounds, which is very consistent and safe. I don't screw up. I can just go into the wall here. Okay, I failed it. Doesn't matter though. Let's try it again. Epa. And just go up on the tunnels where I'm supposed to go. You skip a lot of fighting like this compared to casual playthrough. And we skip a complete enemy wave. There will be turret soldiers spawning here and they can follow you to the next fight and kill you. So I prefer to go out of bounds, especially on the marathon. The didact ship was pulled into space. I will drop in again by thrusting right here. In one another is an innocent folly, but one which darkens her true promise. And this next section is a one fight again with lots of enemies around. It's a difficult section, so let's hope I will not choke it. That's the second warden fight. First of all, I will quick kill this knight. And we got him. Nice. I'm getting unlucky here. It's bad. I tried to salvage it somehow, but it's going to be a bit difficult. Okay, we good. Okay, we're not good. If I'm lucky, Kelly might revive me though. Let's see. Ha! Or maybe not. Doesn't matter, but RNG happens. Okay, this is already much better. He's coming to me right away. Come on. I will Spartan charge him to stun him, and then shoot his back with a scatter shot. There we go. I'm have to clear all the enemies now. No survivors. I'm missing a lot of shots right now. I'm going to insta-kill this guy. There we go. I shot off his armor with a binary rifle and shot his face. That's how he died. Come on. Okay, stop moving. That's good. I'm going in a small rampage here, because why the hell not? Come on. Okay, I might play this safer actually. Now I can do it. Where is he? And this guy has to die. There we go.
Chief, hello?
Waiting for dialogue.
John, you made it. Oh, I can't believe you're here.
Where are we?
You're on a Forerunner world. Designation Genesis. Enough standing around. Let me get the bridge for you. The Warden will be back soon.
You know him?
Oh yes. Fair warning. He has a single mind, but a few million bodies.
Chief said you were destroyed.
After I saw John last, I was pulled into slipspace.
So, yes, you see, this mission has a lot of tricks and skips. But there's more.
How are you still acting? Rampancy.
It's not over yet.
Touching this place.
Coming up in around a minute or so, there's another trick at the end of the mission. Which is also quite interesting to see. I will let it be a surprise to you guys. I won't say what it is about.
Just one more to go.
Cortana, why does the Warden think he needs to protect you from me?
There's so much to explain. It'll be easier when we're face to face.
Try me.
The cure for rampancy I found means AIs.
Again, I'm working there. I'm a wizard.
That kind of lifespan allows for long-term planning, just like the Forerunners were capable of. AIs can assume the Forerunner's mantle of responsibility. And once there is peace, we can focus on poverty, hunger, illness.
This vehicle is called Phaeton. And it's kind of interesting because you can boost like that. Okay, that's the skip. Oh, we're going out of bounds again.
I'll explain it better once we're together. Nice fly.
I have to hit the loading zone here. This trick is a bit difficult, so I might fail it. Let's see. And I'm going to the end of the mission with a Phaeton. If I don't screw up, there we go. That's how you break a game. I say it's around 15 to 20 seconds. The next upcoming mission can be very random, so if I die here, it's totally normal.
You loading up, Commander?
We're gonna see if Halsey can learn to speak Guardian.
I'll have a briefing for you by the time we reach San Helios.
See you, planet's eye.
I forgot to mention about the second mission where you play as Master Chief. There's another one upcoming towards the end.
Arbiter has united the Keeps and formed a new alliance. The Swords of San Helios. With Arbiter's victories and the death of Jewel Amdama, the Covenant remnants grow desperate. They have begun an assault on Vadam lands, targeting Arbiter specifically. You will find Arbiter at the Elder Council chambers.
Okay, this next section can be quite random, and it requires quite a bit of skill and decision-making too. So I might choke this very hard, or I might get first try, let's see. Okay, already being pretty unlucky. Okay, we should be good, I think, if I have good spawns. Okay. Second try. It's not a big deal, a death like that is totally to be expected. Let's get a second try. And I should make it. We're good. Oh, if I die now, it's really unlucky. Okay, thank God. Now, there's another trick upcoming. It's pretty cool. You might like it. First, I'm cleaning the snipers so they won't kill me. Come on. There we go. It's called the drop pod launch. And I didn't get it. Second try. The way it works is there is a drop pod falling. Agreed. It's a pod dropping, there we go. And if you're under it when it spawns, you get pressure launched. I should get it second try, I think. Let's see. There we go. That was a pretty high one too. Jesus. That skips enemies. And is definitely fast on legendary. Because there would be tons of enemies here in normal playthrough. And you'd have to go all the way around and stuff. I should be okay. There we go. This elite is annoying. Where is he? Okay, this section is a bit difficult. I have to spawn kill hunters. And if you remember from blue team, hunters are not easy to kill. Oh boy. Alright, backup strats. Did he die that? He did not die that. Oh, come on. Usually this goes faster, but being a bit unlucky and I choked a bit. There we go, finally.
All clear.
I am approaching your position.
Complimentary teabagging. Because that's how you play Halo.
Your Commander Palmer thought you would find these useful.
I do like the way she thinks.
Covenant reinforcements move on.
This vehicle is called the Mantis, first introduced in Halo 4.
We'll clear a path to the Arbiter. Just be ready for extraction.
I shall await your signal.
Some exoskeleton type of vehicle. Ducking childish, I totally agree. If the teabag was a smart thing to do, I wouldn't do it. Okay, so this section is just fighting. Upcoming section is really difficult and very luck dependent, so let's see. Let's see how this goes. Lots of things can go wrong in this section.
Spartans, the Elder Council chambers are on the far side of that courtyard. Hurry! We have lost contact with Arbiter's forces within.
Copy that. Let's get the Arbiter out of there.
What I need to do is I have to kill enough enemies to open the door. Oh, I got pretty lucky. That's good.
Door's opening.
Okay.
Stand by, Moxie. We'll get to the Arbiter soon.
That was good RNG.
Insertion bot, hit gun. Push through, Osiris. Maki, we've reached the council chamber.
Understood. On my way.
Kaidon! Soru! Kaisuka!
Don't die.
Swords of San Helios will be victorious!
Okay, we're good. And that was a San Helios. Next mission upcoming is an autoscroller. I think it's 1 minute and 9 seconds long.
Guns down, Osiris. We're guests here.
Locke, I have a briefing prepared. Given Cortana's show of power, I am reluctant to discuss it over open channels.
Understood, Doctor. We're on our way.
Over here, Osiris. I have located...
You found a way to act.
Nothing much to say about this, just
this
talk to the people at the right time.
A Forerunner tool I can use.
And that's it. Doesn't require a seal or anything.
These were ubiquitous in Forerunner facilities. These hills are riddled with support stations for the Sanghelios Guardian. Palmer has the coordinates of one such station. Finding a constructor there should be simple.
Now I go to talk to Palmer and autoscroll is done.
Ready when you are, Osiris.
We're ready, Commander Palmer.
Okay, let's go.
Good run. Agreed for a marathon, definitely. The thing about legendary speedruns in Halo is that a lot of random factors can screw you over. You can play everything perfectly and can still have very unlucky situations where it's hard to get out from. But I'm going for consistency here in this marathon. Like on Osiris, the second launch I did, there's a faster way. Another launch, but that's on marathon safe. So this mission is called Enemy Lines. It's quite movement heavy. Like movement inside of vehicles and stuff like that.
Commander Palmer, we're in position.
Copy that.
Also fun fact, in this section I'm invincible. I can't die for a few seconds. But no one even shot me, so I guess I can't showcase it. I think I skipped this barrier by just clambering over it. Casual playthrough, you were supposed to destroy a shield core thing, whatever you call it, I don't know what you call it. Alright. For the next section, you're not supposed to take the ghost, but we're doing it anyway because we're speedrunning. By doing a specific jump like this. That's the second barrier. The first one was the two shields down there. We're not supposed to be here. That's the third one. Also very easy to skip. Like so. So we have the ghost in the section. We weren't supposed to have it. And this section requires a lot of precise movement. It's much more difficult than it looks. Trust me on that. You have to be fast enough and not flip over and stuff like that. Way more difficult than it looks. But we're good. If you don't go fast enough, you will... Okay, that's what's happening. But I was going to say, if you don't go fast enough, you're very likely to die there. I died anyway, but that's because I'm unlucky, I guess. It's rare to die like that. If you don't screw up the movement at the beginning. If you get a second try, it doesn't really matter. Okay, we're good.
I'm heading into the temple.
Because there's a beam rifle guy, he can insta-kill you, and there's a wraith, he can insta-kill you. If you're slow, they will be alerted, or the wraith will be dropped down, and they will just kill you every time. Or almost every time. Now in this section, I can't... I'm supposed to kill my allies. I will explain why.
Let's help Arbiter finish this.
Come on. Got all three of them, which is good. So there's a Kraken here. This is vehicle thing, you see. Right in front of us.
I'm on board the Kraken.
Hold on, I have to focus here. So you have to destroy the generator inside. The fastest way to do that in speedrun is build a plasma grenade. And there we go. Oh, that's bad RNG. This might take a while. Okay, we're good. So the reason why I killed my allies is that if they're still alive and you've destroyed the generator, as long as there is an ally inside the Kraken, the death, what you call it, the destruction sequence animation will be delayed. So because I killed them, this thing will be destroyed right away. See it going down. If I hadn't killed my allies, one of them would have already been stuck or died inside. and that I probably lost a lot of time.
Cyrus, that is beautiful work. Kraken's down. Time to grab that constructor. Halsey's coordinates are inside that Forerunner site.
Now the ending of this mission is quite fighting intensive, so I have to focus again. This is definitely one of the harder parts of the game. I only have one goal here, survive. Then you save. Oh boy. So many enemies! Alright, I got a checkpoint though, so it's okay. Oh god. Oh boy. This is going well. Could have been a lot worse, trust me on that. Some enemies left here. Also, the reason why I kill these watchers is they can restore the armor of the enemies. I completely forgot to mention that before, but watchers should be killed as quickly as possible. Okay, we're good.
All clear. Commander Palmer, we have the constructor. Ready for extraction.
Nice work, Spartans. Arbiter, ready for pickup.
I am sending the ship your way, Spartan.
We have an auto-scroller upcoming again, which is also 1 minute and 9 seconds long. Thanks for the good luck, Dutch. Also, hey, Garish. So I think since this is the last auto-scroller mission, it's a good time to say that if you like what you see, if you're interested in Halo running, I can advise you to go to HaloRuns.com. You'll see all the listed records and where you can learn to speedrun the game. So if you're interested about speedrunning this game, that's the place to go.
Dr. Halsey has the constructor.
Good work, Osiris. Once Halsey has the constructor sorted, Arbiter's people can move on Sinion, and I'll get her off-world.
Osiris, come look at this. I'm using this structure to upload the recording from Meridian into the constructor.
But the next upcoming mission is known to be cruel.
Get comfortable.
The checkpoints are really bad on the next upcoming mission.
Headed for Sinion. It's moving towards the Guardian.
Arbiter.
Also, the following cutscene is kind of known to be, how should I say it? It includes the worst speech in all of the Halo history. In the all of the Halo gaming franchise, you will hear the worst speech ever in this cutscene that is coming up. At least according to a lot of people, and I agree on that. I won't let it go through all of the speech because I don't want to have your ears bleed and stuff.
Osiris, form up.
But Tanaka's speech in this section is absolute cringe.
Actually, Tanaka, if I could ask a favor. Just say a word or two.
Come a long way together. A long way yet to go. Let's make a good jump, like we mean to.
I'm skipping that. Sorry, guys. I don't want to see it. It's just too bad. Okay, there's a skip right here. We're going out of bounds again, and I think I failed. I'm reverting to that. Okay, we're good. We skipped a lot of fighting. And because I did the skip, there's another thing later on this mission. I will explain when I get there. If I'm fast enough during the skip, that's why I reverted. Well, this section is quite random, so I have to hope not to die. Looking good? Okay, looking good. I went around to take up the Fuhrer cannon here. I have to go back to hit the loading zone and spawn the enemies. Otherwise I can't finish the mission. So in this section I have to destroy some cannons. That's the first one. Then I have to wait for dialogue.
Cannon destroyed. Swords of St. Helios. Another cannon down on my position.
Affirmative, Spartan. All ships, the Spartans have opened more airspace. Move in and make your presence felt.
Wait for this door to open, and this is also quite difficult. Okay, good. This is a few rod cannon elite, he can insta-kill me.
If it didn't, somebody better come up with another solution real quick.
Dr. Halsey said the plan would work. I trust him.
Okay, because I skipped the beginning section, I can skip something else here. In a casual playthrough, you have to destroy all three cannons, but if you do that skip for some reason, you have to only destroy two of the other three, saving some time. So this key is quite difficult. I don't know if I got a checkpoint or not. Something is super safe. Also, I'm low on ammo here, so I try to insta-kill them.
Take that elite out. Still too many enemies. Clear the LZ, Osiris.
Come on. Oh boy, that's bad. I have to go semi-risky here. This is going to be fun.
Take him down quick. Our ride's going to leave without us. Keep hunting, Osiris.
Shield is down.
Okay, we're good. As soon as I hear friendly fans approaching, I know that we're good. Should be very soon.
Friendly phantoms approaching.
There we go.
Spartan lock, come in.
Maquis, hello again.
Air defense is still.
I can hear suicide grunt. Oh my god, Elite is following me. I have to play the safe. I really don't want to die here. Okay, we're good.
Thank you, Mark. Osiris, Maquis said there's a way down. Find it.
I lost a bit of time because I had to play it safe. And I missed the SWAT guys because of that. I didn't know that was a thing until now. But alright.
There's an elevator to
This is bad. I have to go for the backup strat.
Find their power source or target the cannons themselves.
I didn't know that was possible. There's usually two camouflage SWAT elites there. And having a SWAT in this upcoming section is a huge advantage. Like, I really need it. There's another way to get a SWAT, but it's way more risky, way riskier, and I'm probably going to die a few times. We will see.
Try not to let it go to my head. Maquis says we'll get direct access to the Guardian Battalion. But remember, we don't have the Swords of Sanctuary.
I have to kill this guy now.
Whatever gets us to the Guardian.
We good. Super. That was really good. Waiting for a checkpoint here. No matter how long it takes, I'm waiting. There we go.
Guardian's still too far. Hurry.
This section is very RNG heavy, so I'm probably going to die. That might be good. And again, a hunter fight.
Stand by. We're on it.
I just tried to spawn kill him. There we go. Easy peasy. There's an invisible SWAT elite here. I just have to try to survive pretty much. There is a small glitch here. It doesn't save time, but it's kind of fun to do. And go below the elevator like that. I'll be warped again. 3, 2, 1, warp. Okay, I was a bit early, but still. There's another skip upcoming here. It only saves like 2 to 3 seconds. There's a wave animation, and you have to sit through it. But if you assassinate this crawler, they're waiting for a bit. You can skip it and just run through. If you do it too early, it's bad because your angle gets locked and you can't look around you anymore. Until you revive one of your allies, so you have to wait for a bit. Bad movement. And there's a long ending fight coming up here.
Pushing Osiris, we're almost to the Guardian.
Oh, I don't have any grenades, interesting. I have to play this safe. Ok, Okay, there's a huge wave of soldiers spawning here. I have to kill all of them. Oh, good checkpoint. That's nice. Another wave spawning. Come on, get in. Good.
All that matters is the Guardian hasn't left yet. There's still time.
Now I have to fight the one Eternal again after I kill like two crawlers or something. Should be getting a checkpoint right before it. Okay, this guy, and then the warden is coming. Come on. There we go.
How the hell is that thing here? We killed it.
We don't have time to discuss it. Take him out, Osiris.
You dare raise arms. You just kill him with power weapons from up top. Ooh, that's really unlucky. That's the worst case scenario, actually. Okay, we good.
What's a Genesis?
That was Battle of Sunion. It was one of the tougher missions, so I'm happy that's over with. We're on a pretty good pace right now. This mission is called Genesis, and the beginning part of it might be the favorite part of the game for a lot of people. Because it looks pretty cool.
Activate mag boost.
But it's also a bit difficult, like I have to hit all my shots here. Not all of them, but if my aiming is off I will die. And dying here loses a lot of time. Okay, looking good so far.
Stay in the middle, watch out for gap. Rollers ahead, don't stop, shoot and run.
Oh boy, here we go. Oh, that's pretty solid. Nice. Alright. Now, in this part of the game, we're going fast by going slow. Sounds stupid, but I'll explain it. If you go too fast here, you will get an extra dialogue by Cortana. So if you just go a bit slow, like not the fastest you can. I'm going zigzags here. I will skip the dialogue. I'm hitting this toaster thing for good luck, I guess. Since Cortana didn't say anything and Tanaka said, so this is the right place, I know that I got the dialogue skip. There's another really cool trick upcoming, if I don't fail. It's a bit RNG dependent, I might die here if I'm unlucky, let's see.
Yeah, I reckon we can make use of that. I found it among
Let's see, first try. Looking pretty good so far. Okay, I think I got it. So what we're doing here is phantom surfing. The grandpa of this phantom. And we can ride it. But because that's already old, we've done that before, and not cool enough, we'll do it with this one too. Phantom switching. Oh, I got pretty unlucky. That's a rare death. Doesn't matter, we can do the trick again, I guess.
Accessing your communication systems. Oh, by the way, there are a number of hostile visitors just outside, so I brought you this. I assume it will be of use to you.
Scorpion? Yeah, I reckon we can make use of that.
I found it among the detritus of Guardian 3209's
problem. Rally up, we just...
Look out!
And we're good again.
Guardian.
So this is the whole thing again. One phantom isn't cool enough, so let's go for two. There we go.
Unfortunately, the defenses will consider you invaders as well.
It's your installation. Can't you tell them to let us through?
No. Between Warden and Cortana, most of my administration privileges have been revoked. But worry not. I still have control of some aspects of this facility.
I have to go back to hit the loading zone for the ghosts. It's going to spawn right there. There we go.
The gateway.
And the Master Chief is there.
Cortana has
this section has a ton of enemies.
If
I go back to here, I spawn all the enemies. I have to do that to finish the mission. This is very RNG heavy, so I might die a few times. There's a strat that makes the whole thing easier. I wait for the phantom to move, which distracts all the enemies. Not all of them, but most of them, if I'm lucky at least. It makes survival much more likely. Yes, you can see the enemies are shooting it and not me. So I just use that opportunity to go through. And there's a skip. I skipped the bridge with precise movement with the ghost. Okay, first try. Enemies didn't kill me, I made through. There's a double warden fight here. I know warden fights are getting old, but it's a common theme in this game. Fight all the wardens. I skip an enemy trigger here by flying over the ramp. Otherwise there would be a lot of enemies and two wardens, which is quite frankly a bit of overkill. The way I died is I got EMP'd by the warden. It's a one-shot kill if it hits me. There we go. EMP'd again, but he didn't hit me, so I survived. This black thing is following me. Whoa! Ah, oh, that's pretty unlucky. Doesn't matter, I'm having fun dying. Who doesn't want to die all the time? I'm having pretty bad RNG here. Okay, now it's okay. Finally. By the way, the weapon I picked up before is called the Answer. It's a saw. And it has explosive rounds. It's one of the coolest weapons in the game. There we go, one number one. I'll read the chat very soon, guys. I'm a bit focused right now. One grenade should kill him. There we go. Now, since I skipped the enemy trigger at the beginning, I have to go back and hit it to finish the mission. And I got the checkpoint, which is good. All the enemies I skipped are spawning now, and I just go through like nothing. Distro, shame the chat is so quiet. It's not a big deal. If people are entertained, I'm happy. Gave you a follow, thanks man.
Please, wait.
Appreciate it.
She's dangerous. I know.
This is the second last mission, and this is the last Master Chief mission. We're pretty good on the timer. I will probably not be anywhere close to the estimate. My estimation would be 2 hours and 5 minutes, but it's hard to predict right now. This mission has a lot of fighting. And I'm playing it safe because I don't want to die. There's a faster strat at the beginning that I'm not doing now. There's crawlers spawning here, you can just skip them and run through, but I'm not doing it in the marathon. It loses quite a bit of time, but I don't want to die unnecessarily for going risky. So we're just killing all of these guys. A bit of bad RNG, but I should manage. I'm weapon comboing. I'm using the bolt shot, which is this weapon, to take off the armor of the soldiers, and headshot with a pistol to kill them. It's a pretty good method to kill them. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, that's pretty unlucky. Well, you saw the watch to do there is give the shield back to the soldier. And this is a suppressor, same principle as a bolt shot. Good to take off the armor of the soldiers. Come on. I need to kill that crawler. Come on. He's playing hide and seek. I don't like that. There we go. And spawning tons of other enemies right now. But I got the checkpoint, which is good. Good shot. I need the second knight to go down. Good shot. The thing about Halo runs, recalled here, is that you should keep the estimate high, because in Legendary a lot of things can go wrong. This run is surprisingly good. And I have to stress that out, it's surprisingly good for Marathon. I started the gondola and I'm going back to take the incineration cannon. I'm fast enough at least. There we go.
It's so good to see you again, John. So good to see all of you. Back together as a family.
Psychological tactics. Saying my name. Playing nice.
What would you have me
do? By the way, I think the biggest skip of the game is at the end. Like, the biggest skips of the game are in the ending missions. On this one, you will see what I'm talking about, and on Guardians, there's some insane skips coming up. The first part of this mission is really fighting intensive, I know that. It's all the Master Chief missions for some reason. But after that, trust me, it's going to be interesting. This room is a bit special. The way it works is, you have to hit 4 triggers, or 3, I'm not sure. Wait, 3 triggers that are spread across the section. And I'm distracting the enemies to spawn down there. And just go in reverse, hit the triggers, and try to skip the section, more or less. I killed some enemies for safety, because otherwise they would probably insta-mold me or something. This is legendary after all. Still alive. Okay, that crawler has to die. Okay, the first trigger is here, down here. I just hit it. The second one is up here, and I spawn all the enemies. I just run quickly so I don't die. And the third trigger is up here. You can see it because all the enemies are spawning now. And I only have to kill these 4 enemies that just spawned. The 2 sentinel beams and the 2 soldiers. And I can just go through. Come on. Open your eye, beautiful. There we go. Oh, that's an interesting checkpoint. I've never had that one before. That's a really good one. And there we go, I don't find all the enemies down there.
Cortana's letting this happen. She could rein Warden in if she wanted to. I'm thinking the same.
This is the last clear we have to do in the speedrun. It's a pretty big one. Insta-killing the binary rifle soldiers. And then taking care of these guys, who can also insta-kill me. Of enemies. The way they split is a bit unfortunate, but as long as I don't die, I really don't care. That's the last one. Oh, took second last, alright. Again, I'm working on air. Whee!
Even if you don't agree with my plans.
Okay, now some major insane skips upcoming. If you've played through the game, the next room has tons of enemies. Knights, Binary Rifle Soldiers, Normal Soldiers, insane amount of enemies. Hey Hobo, this is not World Record, but it's a pretty good pace for a marathon. We're going to skip all this, all that room, all the section. We save us a lot of fighting, minutes and minutes of time save because we don't have to do the fight. It's a bit of a difficult trick to execute, so I might fail a few times. It's to be expected. What I'm going to do is... You're going to see it in a second. Getting checkpoints. So what I'm doing here, or attempting to do at least, is a pressure launch. Third try, come on. Okay, that was too slow. Here we go. And we can ground pound an invisible platform here. I skipped this whole room. It would have a lot of enemies in casual playthrough. And this section is infamous, it's a triple warden fight. In the casual playthrough you have to kill three wardens. And it's insanely difficult. But we're speedrunning, so we don't do that. There's a very easy skip that we're going to do now. We're not fighting the wardens, we're just skipping. So, that was the triple warden fight, ladies and gentlemen. Very difficult. Oh wait, we don't have to fight them. Last mission upcoming, and last mission is around 6 to 7 minutes long if I don't screw up. Was a long cutscene. So this is the last mission.
Wait. I tried to warn them and, well, here we are.
Once Chief knows the destruction Cortana's caused,
this mission has gone through a lot in the speedrunning. In a casual playthrough, you have to destroy 5 cores and then go to a building where you have to do a huge, a really, really long ending fight with tons of enemies. Really difficult, really. And there was a skip found to skip the ending fight by clipping with the water through the ground. That got patched. And we had a problem that we knew the trigger was going to be patched and we didn't know what to do because we couldn't skip the ending fight anymore. And that's like a 7-minute skip or something on Legendary. First of all, wait, let me kill my allies. It's a reason why I do that, hold on. I'll explain it soon.
Watch out.
But there was a new skip found in this mission where you don't even have to destroy the 5 cores at all.
Where did it go?
It's technically possible to finish this mission pacifist.
Exuberant.
Without shooting any enemies at all. But I'm not doing that because of safety reasons. So I can make my allies fly now. There we go.
Off to bring peace. The monitor called it a threat of death.
Because fuck physics, I guess.
Of my birth. You were built, not born.
Oh yes, AIs are just.
So the reason why I killed them is they will respawn at the strategical time where I need them to do something specific.
You expect other AIs to join you.
Also, what I did now is a boost. It wasn't a good one. You can get a better one. But I can keep the momentum from the gondola to jump halfway into this room.
And now the time has come to ask, who will accept my offer? Who will help me bring an everlasting peace to the galaxy?
This is Cromwell, Shipboard AI, UNSC Melbourne.
Spawn killing Banyera, so just for safety. This section is RNG heavy. And I'm having, I think, bad RNG, I can't see it. No, we should be good. I played it well. Open your eye, baby. There we go. Okay, so my allies respawn right about now. Okay, they're here now. I was sending them to shoot this core. I don't have to do that, but they will give me a checkpoint after they destroy it, unless I'm really unlucky or something. So in the casual playthrough, we would have to destroy 5 cores, but we found a skip for that, so that's not a thing anymore, thank god. We are going out of bounds. You think this is insane? Wait a bit, it's going to be better. I'm waiting for the checkpoint. There we go. That's because my allies destroyed the core. It was all planned. This section is a bit tricky, the out of bounds. Let's see. Got it. This is where the ending fight would be in normal playthrough. Nothing is loaded because we haven't destroyed the cores and haven't pushed the button to do that. But we will just hit the trigger and hover in midair. I will spam jump because I get teleported and I'm on Sonic Runs right now. I hit the ending trigger of the game. There's dialogue and it will end, it will load the ending. I have to time it correctly, otherwise I have a soft lock. Okay, this is good. Now the ending is loading. There's another trick coming up, it's called the relay animation skip. At the end of the run, you hit the button. And that thing up there is called relay. And there's an animation where you open the hull and stuff, it takes like 40 seconds. You can skip that. If you thrust it to the ending trigger and get hit by a wave at the same time. I might fail it, but let's see. Got it. Okay. So I skipped 40 seconds of animation sequence and this is the end of the run. The time is in around half a minute or so, so you should be ready for it. I should mention the sword I had was a special one. The Warple Talon is called like that. You can double thruster with it and you can hover in the air for longer.
Exuberant. What is structures? This is a builder facility after all. I was installed by the builders. I serve the builders.
No. Stop it! So as soon as the blue sphere approaches, there's a black screen, and I will say time when that happens. The last frame or fade out is where you stop the timer. Alright, get ready. And time.
Alright, 2 hours, 3 minutes. And 43 seconds.
That was really good for a marathon, I'm happy. Alright, I want to thank Digimon Marathon for having me. It was fun.
Yeah, thank you for running for us. Nice for having you.
Should I cut the stream now?
No. First I'm going to transition.
Okay.
Right, next up, right after the little thing, we have Jet Set Radio, ran by Flashy Nikla.